लाइव ना जाएगी। Midnight, I say we lose control. I'm never gonna Good afternoon, everyone, and let us prepare for ourselves for the invocation and the singing of National Anthem.
Humble themselves and pray.
According to John Ruskin, education is a painful, continual, and difficult work to done in kindness, by watching, by warning, by praise, but above all, by example. Good afternoon and welcome to Father Saturnino Orius University Teacher Education Program, Teachers College Hugpong Alumni Association Webinar on Magkatunta o Google Classroom. Once again, maayong hapon kanatong tanan mga kaguro. So I would like to thank all the participants who are watching live to our YouTube channel. So we have here some participants from all over the region. So we have from Dinagat Island. So we have from Bisig City. We have from Surigao City. Then we also have from Surigao del Sur. Then we have from Agusan del Norte participants. Then we also have from Agusan del Sur. And of course, we have from Butuan City. Okay, thank you very much. Just stay tuned. Then don't forget to subscribe our channel for your future, for our future webinars. Okay. Once again, thank you so much. And now, and now, to give us an opening remarks, let us all welcome the President of the Hugpong Alumni Association, Ms. Hazel Badayos.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good day, everyone. Dean of Teachers Education Program of Father Saturnino Orius University, Dr. Arlyn M. Florita. Our speaker, Engineer Orlando Richie R. Natunton. Officers and members of FSUU Teachers Education Program, Teachers College, Hugpong Alumni Association. Participants all over the country, good afternoon. Quarantine time need not to be an productive, especially for us teachers who embracing the teaching in the new normal, the remote instruction. For this new academic school year 2020-2021 that will start this month of August, reshaping schooling perspective and practices will answer on the way and the what and the how and why of the educational instruction. And today's webinar is one of the online tools, resources, where teachers often use. Together, Magkatunta o Google Classroom. As the president of FSUU Teachers Education Program, Teachers College Hugpong Alumni Association, I welcome you all in this webinar. Enjoy. Have fun, and we are all learn this kind of activity. God bless everyone and mabuhay.
Yes, thank you, Ma'am Hazel Badayos, for that warm welcome. So I hope everyone felt that welcome. So just stay tuned. And now I will turn you over to Ma'am Maricris Abuan for the acknowledgement. Ma'am?
Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of Father Saturnino Orius University Teacher Education Program, Hugpong Alumni Association, I would like to commend the effort of the following alumni officers and advisor who made our first webinar entitled Magkatunta o Google Classroom Possible. Planning Committee, Dr. Edmund D. Mendoza, Dr. Arlene M. Floreta, and Madam Hazel T. Badayos. Program Committee, Madam Hazel T. Badayos, Sir Gerard L. Lopez, Sir Ronald Alan H. Butalik, and yours truly. Technical Working Group, Sir Gerard L. Lopez, Madam Elaine C. Bayer, Ma'am Lilibeth Y. Bunghanoy, Ma'am Francis D. Kaumpay, Sir Princeton Lu Ubungkayaw, and Sir Asahel D. Alcantara. Supporting Team, Ma'am Hazel T. Badayos, Sir Ronald Alan H. Butalid, Sir Princeton Lu Ubungkayaw, Ma'am Marinelle Pedrosa, and Sir Ian J. Pamantian. And our webinar advisor, the Dean of Teacher Education Program, Dr. Arlene M. Floreta. Thank you everyone for the support, and let your light shine.
Yes, thank you very much, Ma'am Marie-Chris Abuan. So let our light shine. So that is the motto of our beloved alma mater. And now, let us all welcome Dr. Edmund Mendoza for the statement of purpose. Sir?
Okay, my respect to Dr. Arlene M. Floreta, the Dean of the Teacher Education Program of Father Saturnino Hoyos University, to our Alumni President, Ms. Hazel T. Badayos, to the alumni officers, to the technical working group who made this webinar possible, to our dear teachers in the public and private schools, maayong hapon sa inyong tanan. The Department of Education issued a policy guidelines on the implementation of learning delivery modalities for the formal education. Thus, it introduced the distance learning of online, modular, TV radio-based instruction and blended learning. In the initial stage of preparation conducted by the school leaders, an assessment is being rolled out to assess the readiness of the school on specific areas of concern like learning resources, learning management, teacher capacity, household and community capacity, and school operations. The task to shift from traditional face-to-face instruction to distance learning is indeed a challenging responsibility to provide quality instruction to our learners. In the new normal, the support extended by the parents, community, barangay LGU, LGU, and private individuals and institutions are relevant to move forward working to transition the modality of teaching from the conventional face-to-face learning to blended learning, which is a combination of distance learning and in-person delivery of learning materials to the homes of the learners. In the report written in Philippine Daily Inquirer 2 months before classes opened on August 24, only 40% of the 800,000 teachers across the country have been trained so far for distance learning. However, our teachers are doubling their time and energy to learn new things on what technology can provide to them in spite of the limited resources that the Department of Education can provide to the teachers and learners. Thus, the TEPTC Hugpong Alumni Association, in cooperation with FSUU Teacher Education Program, comes up with a humble project that would equip our Filipino teachers on DepEd's recognized learning management system of Google Classroom. This project of the Alumni Association is our own way of extending assistance to the public and private school teachers who are driven to deliver quality instruction in equipping themselves the necessary knowledge, skills, attitudes, and values on the different distance learning delivery modality. The Alumni Association truly believes that our teachers may be struggling to undertake difficult tasks in difficult circumstances. Distance learning is imperfect. Disadvantaged students come even more disadvantaged, but millions of students are continuing to learn, to kindle their fires because teachers are persevering. We acknowledge and celebrate doctors, nurses, policemen, and other responders who have worked so hard and accomplished so much during this pandemic. Let us celebrate that teachers are education's first responder. To end, let us all explore the world of technology together as we embrace the change in the educational landscape. Thank you, and God bless us all.
Thank you very much, Sir Edmond. Sir Edmond is currently connected at the DepEd Caraga Regional Office as Education Program Supervisor, Quality Assurance Division. Thank you so much, Dr. Mendoza. Then at this time, let us hear a message, inspirational message from the Dean of Teacher Education Program of Father Saturnino Orius University, Dr. Arlene Floreta. Ma'am? Ma'am Arlene, naka-mute ka, ma'am. Yes, that's it, ma'am.
Sorry for that. Thank you so much for the reminder, Sir Jaran. So, maayong hapon sa tanan. A pleasant and COVID-free afternoon to one and all. It's a bit gloomy, no? Kay murag, it rained this morning and maybe in some parts of Caraga. It's still raining. But I want to begin my little task this afternoon by pointing out the sunny side of what's going on around us. Obviously, the pandemic context. The unseen enemy had not stopped the spirited individuals from reaching people far and wide to learn and upskill as professionals, all for free. If there is one thing that I can count as good thing in this pandemic, this is it, when the professional development is becoming free. In this challenging time, the once so pricey professional development programs that we need to attend have cost us so much. We used to pay around 4,000 pesos just to attend a seminar, and we need to board a plane, ride a bus, or sail, and even care on what to wear just to learn new things or learn all things in new perspective. But this time, all we need is a load to keep us connected while learning in the comfort of our home. And I pray that in whatever connections we are now, that will sustain us until the end of this program. So I could see that we really are the stronger and the most adaptable creature made by God. I commend the Teachers College or the Teacher Education Program, Hugpong Alumni Association, led by Miss Hazel Badayos and her team, not only her fellow officers, but also her supportive batchmates and friends, for this webinar on Magkat Unta o Google Classroom. Truly, the Orient Spirit has kept us alive to shed light where there is a possible gloom. So this is a timely event when classes are about to start, and maybe some of us have not decided on what learning management system to use to facilitate online learning. And we have heard the data from Dr. Edmond Mendoza that teachers are really in quandary, you know, in which LMS to use and how to go or to move forward in these trying times. So fellow educators, we know that once a teacher is always a learner. So let us not outgrow the passion and love for learning, because the better equipped we are, the more effective we also are in facilitating learning among our students. Perhaps this uncertain time have kept us unprepared. We maybe are afraid, but not totally shaken. We maybe are kept safe in our homes, but not really fallen. All the more, we are stirred to share and help one another to keep up and emerge victorious over this challenge placed before us. So I don't want to eat more of your time, especially of the speaker's time. Let me just leave you an acronym for this afternoon, and that is to learn. L-E-A-R-N. So we could remember easily. And that is to learn eagerly and reanimate ourselves in the new normal. Happy learning, everyone. Good day.
Thank you very much, Dr. Floretta, for that inspiring message. Yes, once a teacher, always a learner. So we should keep on learning as a teacher. And now, before we're going to introduce our resource speaker, I would like to please help me welcome my co-moderator, Sir Ronald Alan Butalin. Sir, can you tell something what our participants will do after the conference? So ano yung gagawin po nila? Nakamute po kayo, sir. Sir Alan? Nakamute
po? Yes, sir. Okay, so right after the talk of the speaker, if you have questions, then please write on the comment section your questions, your queries, kung namo yung mga kalibog sa inyong mga sa about sa talk ni Sir Richie Natundon, then write it in the comment section. And after this webinar, don't forget to send your evaluation so that you can get your certificates. So I hope you will enjoy our activity for tonight, and God bless everyone.
Thank you, Sir Butalid, Sir Alan Butalid. I like the plant behind you, Sir Alan. Okay, and now,
back to you, Sir Gerard. So again, right after the talk of our speaker, don't forget to write in the comment section or type in the comment section your questions, your queries about the topic on the Google Classroom. So Google Classroom is an application enjoyable and then at the same time helpful in this time of pandemic in which kitatanan, we really need to have the online learning for our students. Okay, so kana mga simple yung questions ha, ayaw po na mga lisod kayo. Ayaw, wala mo question about love, charot. Okay, so, yes, Sir Gerard. So I think we're having a technical glitch. And then, so I would like to thank everyone for joining this free webinar sponsored by the Alumni Association of the Teacher Education Program and the Teachers College. Thank you so much for being with us, and I know that you are very busy with activities. So I think the connection is getting in and out. So I think we are experiencing some technical glitch. So just hold on. Kung gusto mo mo inom og tubig, gusto mo mamulbos, gusto mo mag chill sa panagsa, then pwede ninyo nabuhaton. And then we would like to thank everyone sa nagkalain-lain yung mga places around Carag region. We have from Dinagat Islands, nakita from Dinagat Islands, from Agusan del Sur, Agusan del Norte, from Butuan City, of course. Nakita na ako kung mga kabatchmates from Urios College, Teacher Education. So this activity is in line as the Center of Development, Teacher Education Program of FSUU is the Center of Development of Caraga Region. So nice, this is a nice activity para ma-share na mo kung unsay dapat buhaton, kung unsay unsaon ang Google Classroom and all. Okay, so shout out sa mga participants from Butuan City SPED Center, Butuan City Division. So I think nagitay technical glitch nga mahinahitabo, and then ako ra gid ang naa sa stage sa Steam Yard. So ako na lang sa imo chika. So stay tuned everyone. Hinay lang gid kayo ang connection. Hinay ang connection, and then ato lang pabuto lang sa si Sir Gerard to come back. Shout out from Agusan National High School, teachers from Butuan City Division. Salamat kayo, ma'am, sa inyong pag-join sa atong webinar. We also have from Butuan Central Elementary School, yes, we are live GDI. Kinahanglan tayo mga kuan. Mga technical glitch nga nahitabo. Shout out from the Dinagat Islands. From Tubaho National High School. Buhangin Elementary School, Buhangin, Butuan City. Magandang hapon sa lahat at sa aking kapwa-guro sa kagawaran ng Pilipino ng Agusan National High School. Hi to my classmate Era Iting. Shout out sa mga taga Riverside Central Elementary School, Butuan City Division. Shout out from Nueva Estrella Elementary School, Cajana West District, Dinagat Islands. Hello sa inyo tanan, and I hope you will enjoy. Nalang mag-i-adjust gamay. Hi to Felix Timoteo and Jason Andales from DepEd Agusan del Norte. Shout out from Bilay Elementary School and Teacher Education Program Batch 2018. Si Candy Claire. Estudyante na ako sa una. Shout out from Butuan City School of Arts and Trade, Cynthia Radasa, my former colleague. Shout out from Quezon Elementary School of Albor, Dinagat Islands. Ay, nag-shout out na may tanan. Shout out from Panamaon Elementary School, Loreto District, Dinagat Islands Division. Okay, so while waiting for...
Okay, we're back.
Yes, Sir Jiran, I think Sir Jiran is here.
Nagkaka-blackout kami dito.
Hi, Sir Jiran.
So that is a reality of new normal.
Correct.
Okay, so to give us the introduction of our speaker, let us all welcome Ma'am Frances Kaumpay. Ma'am? Please unmute, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to our free webinar on Magkat Unta, on Google Classroom. I am so honored to introduce our competent resource speaker for this afternoon's activity. Our speaker is an instructor 3 at the Engineering and Technology Program at FSUU Butuan City. He passed the licensure exam for teachers last September 2017 and completed his Master of Engineering at Xavier University, Cagayan de Oro City last 2010 and his bachelor's degree in industrial engineering at FSUU last 1999. He has passed and received the Google Educator Certification Level 1 from Google for Education last December 2015 and currently awaiting exam schedule for renewal. He was also the founder and first leader of the Google Educators Group in Butuan. Presently, he is the program coordinator of the Industrial Engineering Program at FSUU with work areas in instruction, faculty, students, industry and alumni, laboratories, and research. He teaches computer fundamentals and programming and calculus to engineering students. He also teaches industrial engineering major subjects such as information systems, industrial materials, and processes. He has been a resource speaker and trainer on several seminars and workshops and involving information security as well on Google Suite's training, such as Cybersecurity 101 for computer studies students at FSUU last July 18, 2018, and Cybercrime and Security Seminar Literacy for Criminology students at FSUU last February 7, 2018, e-Butuanon Digital Literacy para sa ALS Learners at Butuan City Public Library last January 12, 2018. First Advanced Science Lecture Series, Cyber Technology and Cyber Terrorism at Agusan National High School, Butuan City. In the year 2019, he devoted his time in exploring and developing assigned subjects using Google Sites and Google Classroom. Presently, he is attending and participating online for his scholarship from DOST Sparta for an online course in data engineering. Attended some trainings at FSUU for FSUU Learn Online Class Development using NEO Learning Management System, LMS, and currently participating in PAC De La Salle Online Distance Learning, UDL, using Canvas LMS. Friends, help me welcome our resource speaker for a free webinar on Magkatunta on Google Classroom. Ladies and gentlemen, a warm of applause for Engineer Rolando Ritzy R. Natunton. Sir?
Hello, Ma. And hi, good afternoon, everyone. Can you see my presentation po? Makita, Sir Gerand? Hello, sir. Can you see my presentation? You can chat just in case. Okay, so anyway, good afternoon and thank you very much for this opportunity. Not yet. Oh, naka-screen share na. Sir Gerand? Paklaro na ba? Ayan, okay. Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Maing hapon sa tanan. Okay, thank you for that warm introduction, ma'am. So before I proceed with my presentation, and hopefully you would have learned something, I would like to thank you, TEP, TC Hugpong Alumni Association, in cooperation with FSU TEP program, the organizers, Dr. Arlene Floreta, the TEP program dean, Dr. Edmond Mendoza, friends, colleagues, participants, thank you for your presence this afternoon. So, good afternoon. I'll try to put this one to full screen. Para mas malaki. Ayun. So, before we jump right away to Google Classroom and look at the technicalities, I believe, I hope that you'd allow me to present a short slides, siguro limang slides lang before I jump to Google Classroom. To stop first, I want you to stop and think what drives us to learn, to facilitate. So there's a short video clip that I want to show to you about It's Not About You. Then we'll try to pause and we're going to check our files. So if you are in a desktop right now, or if you have a computer on your phone, maybe you can check also. We'll check your files and folders. Then later on, when we say go, we will now explore accessing Google Classroom from your Gmail. So I hope you can see the video clip.
Eleven stainless steel pins in the bones, multiple torn ligaments, severe nerve damage in both hands. You were on the table for 11 hours. No one could have done better.
I could have done better.
Some things just can't be fixed.
Life without my work.
It's still life.
Up. Up. Show me your strength.
This isn't the end. There are other things that can give your life meaning.
This is useless.
Maybe it's time to consider stopping.
No, now is exactly the time not to stop, because you see, I'm not getting any better.
The place you're looking for is called Kamartage, but the cost there is high.
How much?
I'm not talking about money.
You're a man looking at the world through a keyhole. You spent your whole life trying to widen that keyhole, to see more, to know more. And now, on hearing that it can be widened in ways you can't imagine, you reject the possibility.
But it doesn't make any sense.
Not everything does. Not everything has to. Surrender, Stephen.
Preach me.
Silence your ego, and your power will rise. Arrogance and fear still keep you from learning the simplest and most significant lesson of all.
Which is?
It's not about you. It's
when it comes to saving you, or the kid, or the time stone, I will not hesitate to let either of you die.
Spare his life, and I will give you the stone.
There may be dark days ahead. Perhaps Kamartage could use a man that strange.
Strange is meant to be the best of us.
So I must have done it for a reason.
You defended the New York Sanctum from attack.
You were born for the mystic arts.
There's a strength to it.
With its master gone, it needs another. Master Strange.
You will never leave.
No, but I froze again and again. And again forever.
Why? Why could your life be protected?
Because one day, it may.
Who are you in this vast multiverse, Mr. Strange?
Tony. There was no other way.
So, dili to siya sine, ha? The most important part there is you need to pause and think, because this will be your driving force to create your one of the most powerful Google Classroom in the world. So anyway, it's not about you. Your time now from 2 o'clock to 4. Hello, can you still hear me? Yeah. Your time now is very sacrificial as well, because imagine this is a family time and all of us are here trying to see if we can learn something from this person, from this strange person. So hopefully you can revisit the video and look deeper to yourself to stop first and don't jump right away to the tool and learn the tool. Have the meaning first. So I just got this picture from my students, which I already missed them. One that drives me why I explore on and on, finding solutions, trial and error, up and down, because probably these kids, these students who are, some of them already professional, are my drive. They motivate, they encourage me to learn and learn many ways, trial and error, to improve myself as an educator. So before I jump to the Google Classroom again, I want all of us to consider this as a big picture, because you are not just a teacher in a particular level. You're a catalyst of change. So it's possible that whatever we create in our learning platform where the learners are exposed to, of course, if it's a formal education, would have a formal transcript plus experiences would help them. Either they would become entrepreneurs or in employment. And at the end of the day, when we make a difference in their lives, we will also probably make a difference in their better living conditions. So I'm just flashing here some employment opportunities that I believe all educators should look into and not just think of what my near student can do, read, write, and do a small thing. Look at how that impact could have when he or she will try to find work online or offline. This is an example of construction engineer, you know, also structural engineer requirements. Ito example on product engineer or industrial engineering, some requirements online. Ito naman mechanical engineering and electrical engineering. In the entrepreneurship side naman, so we have Shopee, we have Alibaba, Google, Facebook, Amazon, and all those startup companies. But before that, of course, most of the students, the question is, if the demand is there, how do we prepare them for all of this? Well, before COVID, they go to school. We teach them traditionally. We even use the same time online technologies before, but it was like isolated only. It was not the real thing that focused before. However, now, online is the most advisable method of learning, no? So in online learning management systems, they are just sample tools. There are many, many tools out there. On your left, that is Canvas. On your center, that's new LMS, where FSUU is currently using for FSUU Learn. And in the rightmost, that's Google Classroom. That's what we'll be exploring later on. So LMS is a platform for hosting a course. Yung MOOCs or yung massive open online courses, like for example, these are the MOOCs, no, yung mga courses niyan. The LMS is the platform itself. So like Neo, Canvas, and even Google Classroom. Here are some studies that I was thinking that you might be interested to look into, and probably you can create an action research about how Google Classroom might be hopefully effective in your own areas. So the first study here revealed that even teachers with no school affiliation and limited technological know-how and experience can effectively set up Google Classroom. So anyone can learn Google Classroom. It's just the time and connection needed. And of course, this one, another study, the students preferred Google Classroom for keeping track of their assignments. So, intro pa lang yun. Welcome to Google Classroom free version. Bakit free version? Kasi there's also a Google Suite version which has different features. Okay pa ba tayo? May thumbs up ba dito? I have another video before we jump No, again. Okay, ready to watch another video? Hopefully okay tayo.
It's about this. The hearts, the minds, the souls of a billion children await us. Through access to information, their worlds will change. It's up to us. Let's give them what they deserve.
It's an amazing time in education right now. It's totally different than the classroom that we grew up in.
We have all our mat that's here, our main screen here.
You just press it and then it opens. See?
Being able to collaborate with their peers, with teachers, with adults, and we are seeing not only engagement, but actual literacy outcomes improve.
In Malaysia, we place a huge investment in the education of our young children.
We're providing 4G connectivity to all schools across the country.
Students will be learning whenever they want, wherever they want, whenever it's convenient for them. It's the future.
Okay, you might be wondering, why am I not using the net right now? So that I'll dedicate the net for our StreamYard. I downloaded these files and everything already in my laptop so that makadedicate ang internet nato sa streaming. Okay? So I hope it's okay for you guys. Kasi pag ninet ko yun kanina, pag nakaklik mo sa YouTube, then it will go slow. So this is one technique. Download na ni mo sa imo laptop. Okay, so what are objectives for the afternoon session? Hopefully, we have 4 outputs. Before accessing Google Classroom, I hope everyone here from Busan Norte, Busan Sur, or entire Caraga, or outside Caraga, has a Gmail. So very, very important that you have your Google email account. Okay? It's also important because we'll be creating a folder. Later, I'll demo to you how to create a folder. Bakit? Kasi you look at your email, and if you notice, if your students or your teachers will email to you, all of the files are cluttered in your inbox. So a folder in the Gmail is very, very important for you to organize your files. The second objective is Google Drive. So it's also important that we would have a folder in your Google Drive, although Google Classroom automatically creates a folder inside Google Drive. And of course, the highlight for the afternoon is develop a Google Classroom sample class with access code. For those who have computers, those who have desktops, it's easier to create the classroom. And the bonus plus, so I'm going to teach you, I'm going to share how you can create a Google site and link that with Google Classroom. Kasi if you give the Google Classroom as a code, the student, supervisor, or anyone would still need to go to Google Gmail, access the Google Classroom, then enter the code. While if you have a Google website, you just give them the site link and that's it. They can explore, which is connected with your Google Classroom. So here are the visual objectives. Hopefully we can have this for the Gmail, for Drive. This is for Google Classroom, and this is the bonus Google site. Okay, so kanina stop, no? Stop kanina, reflect. And it's not about you. It's not even about me. It's about the learners that we have. We also are learners. So the next phase is pause. So check your files. Even how high-tech your tool is, like Google Classroom, new LMS, even Canvas. If your files are not in order and it's everywhere in your desktop like this one, it would be so difficult to work, no? Okay, so pause. Like example, ito, check your desktop. Baka ganito na ang desktop natin. Why very important? Well, I read somewhere in the net that you have to minimize the number of icons in your desktop. Why? Because it eats up your loading time, no? It slows down your computer. So, matingala mo, bakit hinay kaya akong internet? Hinay akong computer? Well, number one, check your desktop. Baka puno na kay istanan and mag-loading siya, no? So, please put that in a proper folder sa somewhere in Drive D, no? If you have using Windows, you technically should have, hopefully you have a Drive C, C for the system files, and D for the data. So very important po yan when you look into your computer. Okay, what else? Aside from your soft copy space or your computer, important also check your workspace. Basi cluttered the mga files and it's everywhere. It's difficult to work. So how are we going to help one another? I found this framework. This is an old framework we have in industrial engineering, which is 5S. No, I think this is also what sila sa quality control they're using, 5S. So which stands for sort, set in order, shine, standardize, and sustain. So ano ba yung sorting? Uncluttered files. Like this one. Supposedly, hopefully, your desktop should look like this one and not this one. Okay ba mga teachers, mga educators? Kasi, again, learning starts from us. So we cannot preach, we cannot work efficiently if talagang magulo. Oo. Anyway, pero na mag-iuban nga, mas ganahan sa lag-ikunan eh. So basig na later. Okay, so something like this, hopefully on desktop na to. Okay, then now we are accessing, okay, free. Free kasi sa Google account is giving you 15 gigabytes. That's the free version. Imagine you have a USB or a hard drive online, which is free, 15 gigabytes. So you open your Gmail, and of course, from your Gmail, you can access Drive. You can also access Google Classroom. So this is a sample of our Gmail, which I think all of you are opening now. You can either want to open it now or just want to look at it, because after our presentation, I'll show you the actual demo, okay? So from your Gmail kasi, ito, this is the part we're going to click so you can access the other apps. Pwede rin naman i-type nato sa URL box ang address sa Google Drive or even Google Classroom. So in your folder, in your Gmail, it's important to have a label. Ang dami ko label. Later, I'll show you daghang kay label. Kay, unsa may target nato? At the end of the day, if possible, fellow educators, fellow teachers, by 5 o'clock, walay sulod ang email primary inbox. Dapat ingani kalimpyo daw. Oo. So, either kung na'y nabilin diha, na'y work done pa ni mo, nga himuunon. So, as much possible, minimize. Put it in folders. So, this one is the accessing the apps with the, they call this one the 9-dot, the upper right corner. So, there are 3 dots and 3699 dots here that you can click and you can access all the Google apps, the daghang apps. Google Drive, of course. In the traditional mode, Google Drive is like your cabinet. So very important on how you arrange your drive, no? Your Google Drive, the folders there. This is a sample from my free account. This is not Suite. So for the purpose of everyone, those who don't have Suite, Google Suite is, for example, if you're in DepEd, I think those who are in DepEd, you have at deped.edu.ph. So that's your Google Suite. There are differences to that, and later if you have time, I can show you some very, very important differences. But for now, for the purpose of everyone, free account atong tanaw. Okay, still create the folder so that you can place files there. Sir, ang tanumong namo ron is Google Classroom and not Google Drive. Unfortunately, it would be easier for you to navigate Google Classroom if you have already folder in Google Drive and some files in Google Drive. Ayan, so from Google Drive, again, you can access the six dots here, upper right corner, and then the apps are there. And here is Google Classroom. Actually, Google Classroom can also be accessed even sa Gmail. Ayan, sana ba yung Gmail ko? Ayan, andun sa baba, si Google Classroom. So it's very flexible. That's why some really would say it's very easy because for the apps, you can go from one part to the other. You can even drag. So it's this sample of Google Classroom in my free account. So napaamong collaborative sample subject namo ni Ma'am Arlene, ni Doc Arlene. And ewan ko kung okay ba si inyo ha, kay I'm a little bit like a maverick. Ano bitong rebuilding kaayo nga. I want to create that if a student would go to my classroom, how would he be interested in staying in my Google Classroom? So I was looking for images, supposedly. Then I end up making my own banner image for the Google Classroom. Ito siya. So Adventures in Algebra. Kung formal siya, Introduction to Algebra or College Algebra 101. And a gamer like me, by the way, I'm also a gamer. Very important is how you become interested in learning those stuff, being curious. So isa dyan kasi yung graphics eh. So eto, ginawan ko. Ang iba, these are predefined templates already. So, don't worry, this is the last video kasi yung second video, it's an old Google Classroom and it uses Suite. So this is a video for Google Classroom Basics, which you can find in Google for Education Teacher Center. So again, what I have learned and shared it to you this afternoon can also be learned, and you can also visit the website and begin and try to, again, yun nga, di ba? Once a teacher, forever, infinitely a learner. So we're all learners. You can always access this and check out for yourself. So this is the last video. Am I too fast? Okay, Ramo. You can chat. Kasi ba si paktas ra kay ko niya basig nagloading. Sirs, ma'am, you can comment. Thumbs up. Okay ra. Can I continue? Ah, sige. Last video. And this video focuses on Google Classroom. I found this teacher Google Education, and I think this will help us also. Thank you. Yay! O, diba? More time to learn, more time to teach. So, anyway, there's a link with the YouTube that I can share kasi I know it's a little bit faster and there are points there that needs really look into and how we can do it online, no? Hands-on, step by step. Ito nga pala are the parts of Google Classroom. For those, again, sa akong pag-intindi this afternoon, it's like an orientation muna, and probably if you have some questions, let's see if I can entertain them, because if you notice on the video, naana siya advanced features on notifying guardians, no, and also those stuff na medyo sa last na. Yeah, very fast. Tatama po kayo. And actually, the video, you can replay it. But since it's a snippet of hands-on on Google Classroom, only the output part ang pinapakita. How to make that output part is very important. So anyway, I'm showing to you now the parts of the Google Classroom. There are technically four parts, four tabs, no? Part na noon. Four tabs ni siya that when you log into your Google Classroom, automatically you'll see it in your top part, this one. So may stream. So siguro bigihin mo sa Google ng stream because it's flowing, no? The stream part kasi here, it's like your homepage. That's the first part that students and guardians, supervisors, even you will see when you go into Google Classroom. So this is where massively communications, you can post here questions. In my example here, I posted the website for the sample algebra class. So ito yung stream. It's a part where you can communicate with your students. But in Google Suite, aside from the title of your class, this is the section that I included, Teacher Education Program 1-1. Baka pwede natin i-push to for CPD, Continuing Professional Development Units, para section TEP. And then the class code that you're going to give your students. In Google Suite kasi, there's a part here that you can include here, the Google Meet link. So you can meet your students online and have a chat, have a video conversation with them. So ano pa bang nasa stream dere? Select theme. So if you select theme, you will be prompted with predefined graphics para sa banner. Pag upload photo, if you click upload photo, ito na yung photo na i-upload like na ako. So later we'll explore this one, don't worry. So oras na ba? Ah, napatay almost an hour. So the next part is classwork. Now, this part is where you put your lessons. Lesson 1, lesson 2, lesson 3, so on and so forth. Or as a maverick, I change it to leveling. Ayan, so may level 1, level 2, level 3. So you can be creative in this part. And later I'll show you this icon sa pagbutangan na diha. But if if a class is needed to be very formal and kailangan lesson 1, lesson 1 git ibutang kay mogingon ni mga principal nga mogi na ang label nimo diri sa ibabaw. So that's okay. You can always rename this one. So the classwork again is where you put your lessons, materials, assignments. So ito yun. Sa people, so sa people tab naman is sa teacher. So you can add co-teacher. So for example, there are 10 of you will be teaching algebra and 10 professors, 10 teachers have ideas. So you can add your friends and co-teachers here. And of course, this is where the students are found. That's your email. Yung picture ko sa grade 3. And of course, the grades, the tab where the grades are found, no? And here you will find the progress of your learner. Okay. And of course, part sa grade kasi, if you click sa grade, you can export it to comma separable variables ba? CSV, if I'm not. If I'm wrong, so paki-check na lang. Again, you can download it to CSV form or you can copy all grades to your Google Sheet. and to your Excel if you want to analyze the grades. Oh, as a bonus part, this is the Google site. So, ito yung Google site, Google website na connected sa akong Google Classroom. So, guardians, parents, and anyone who's kind of interested just to check your website, you can even visit my website right now. It's ito, sites.google.com/view/algebra-explorer. This is crucial kasi I hated math. I didn't like math. Math was like a cross for me. And probably that's part why I'm kind of passionate of exploring ways to really learn about mathematics. One way to learn, easier to learn, is when you make the subject like a gamified game. So medyo na yung mga adventures of algebra. Can you help algebra in solving problems? So on and so forth. So Google site. So this is a sample of the how Google site looks like that you can edit. Okay. And then ito, actual demo na tayo. Uy, medyo hanap ang wording, sir. Malibat ko. Taysa. Asa dapit? Ah, oh. Kasi ito, I'll show you naman later. Okay, so demo muna tayo. For those who have desktops, paspas ra kun. Okay, hinayon ako karon sa desk sa desktop. Kinsa na kun amoy computer karon nga naay browser, pwede ta mag open inyong browser. Ayan. Klaro na ba? Okay. Then kindly go to your email. Okay, so kusog po ng ulan dire. Ayan, sig ulan. So basig mo siguro blurred. Okay, basig blurred siya because network. Anyway, I'm now giving a actual demo, a live demo. On first is your Gmail ito. Asa dapat ang gusto niyo i-bold para ma-clear? Pass-pass na daw ko. Medyo hanap ang wordings. Saan ang wash hands? Okay. Nanay ko student sa GEG dire. Anyway, thank you for coming this afternoon. Okay, so okay na. I'm showing you my email, my Gmail. Ito. So our first task is to create the folder. Kung nanay naka-create ng folder, the better. Sa katong wala pa, you can scroll your folders. Actually, dito, daghan kay kong folders na raw. Napag-i-bill sa anay ko. So, and then sa baba, pinakababa, and click mo more. And there, you have create. Okay, thanks. Create new label. Ayan. So, for example, if you send me an email, I can move it to this email, to this label. Ayan. So, for example, create new label and then lagay ko PET Alumni 1 kasi ito yung first daw na webinar sa PET Alumni. Tama ba ko? Okay. So, ito na. Create na. So, because letter T naana sa ubos. Ayun. So, naana si TEP alumni. Walay sulod, of course. Kaya pa mo nag-email sa ako. Ah. So, if someone sends me an email, sige nga, sample natin. Ayaw po di flood. Anyway, sige. Please try to send an email. I just want to check kung kinsa tong naka-access og email karon para I would have a visual kung tanan ba mo naka-on inyong Google, inyong Gmail, kay hopefully we can have this part, no? ornatonton@gmail.com. Maklaro? Product-on na to. Please send email. Oops. Girl. Klaro na? tao. My choice was sa quality para dili hanap tanawon. Laubi tao, no hanap-hanap gamay. Clear siya sa akong desktop, pero pag abot sa StreamYard, medyo blurry gid siya. Sa hapadakon pa na ako para maklaro ninyo ang email. Control plus. I-try na ko bigger ang font para maklaro kay blurred daw. Blurred gid siya gamay sa ano, sa StreamYard. Sir Nathan, basig sa StreamYard ni Sir Hadili ko sure. So, okay. So, anyone out there, friends, colleagues sa Caraga, please send me an email. Di klaro sir, kay cellphone ra ko gamit. Okay, it's okay. It happens. This is the new normal. Even my students, naka-cellphone, free data pa. So, anig yun siya. Email ad po. O, lagi nag-blurred gamay. O, teka ha. Try na ko. O, pages. Oops, sorry. Kana siya. Adjust video resolution perhaps in by rate quality. Asa man ang adjustment diri? Mic. Wala eh. Sinwala pa. Anyway, for those who can, kung clear sa ilaha akong email, clear naman, sir. Okay, thank you. Kindly send me an email so that ma-demo lang na ako sa inyo, ha, how to put your emails or your students' email to the folder na itong i-create ka na siya. De? Kanawa na to si inbox. Ah, nanay duha. Aw, wala pag-ibi ay. Okay, I'm waiting. Ayan, meron. Ay, very good! Okay, so, oh, ma'am, thank you. Ningkamot. Si Ma'am Roxanne Princeton, hello. Okay, for example lang, sa katong mong send pagyod, okay lang, may problema. So, for example, these are your students, and you tell them, please send me an email for your feedback and your inquiries sa atong klase. You click this corner here, pwede po kung gusto isa-isahon nimo sila. Lain-laon nimo, for example. Or you can just click this one here. And you have all of them selected. And then move to. Katong folder nga itong gihimo kanina. So move to, ano man to? PEP. LMNOPQST. Ayan. PEP alumni. Yan. So, move lang natin lahat sila sa TEP. Unless na mo'y masuggest nga auto-ani. Ganito, medyo ang gagawin natin. QRST, TEP alumni. Ayan. So, in your folder, if you notice, if you go to your folder, hanapin natin sa TEP. So, ayan. So, now you have the emails of your students or any inquiry regarding to your subject. So, pwede rin like Algebra 1 ang imo folder. Bakit? So that your emails here in the inbox won't be cluttered. Di ba yun yung first S natin actually is sorting. So, look at the files. Basig nagkabuagya yung files sa desktop. So, it's time, it's highlight to change, you know, for a better modality or online work. Mas efficient kasi siya. So, yan. Sige, keep it coming. So, later na ako siya i-copy then put sa TP. So, that's the folder, how to create a folder and how to place all your student's email to the folder to get organized. You might need it later sa Google Classroom if you need to add some students or some email in the past. Okay, so next step is Google Drive. Now, very, very important si Google Drive. So again, balik ko. Okay na, can we proceed with Google Drive? Just leave in the comment nga, sir, we can proceed na to Google Drive so that I would know. Okay, basig nag, like sa uban, sorry kaayo, labi na cellphone mode. And of course, cellphone pa ganyan, loading. So basig malangan. Okay, so next up is Google Drive, which you can access here sa Google Apps. And then you click Google Drive or Drive. So this is your drive, very important. You notice na anay folder nga classroom. Kasi technically, if you have Google Classroom, pag nag-sood naman ko Google Classroom sa una, automatically it will create a folder classroom. And of course, nadiatanan imong mga subjects. No? But for the purpose this afternoon, for the exercise, we're just going to create a folder. Kay basic di ay ma-delete ning sulod sa classroom, at least na kay backup, no, just in case. So you can create new folder and then lagay natin dito TEP Gapod, TEP Alumni 1. Yan. So now you have a folder, Google Drive folder, ito, which you can use for your class or for your organization. And actually, ang nakanindot sa Google Drive is the share feature. No? So, pag-click ni mo na, i-click ni mo ning, if you're gonna click this icon, share this folder, you can share the folder to your co-teachers. Okay? You can share this one to your co-teachers, or for example, na kay gusto i-sharean sa isa ka-email, so you go back and you look at the email. And ayan, so for example, si timingan si Ma'am Vivian Buendia, 91. For example, copy ko yan. And I go to TEP Alumni 1. Share this one. And depende sa imo ha, if in case that, so in case that you would like, ayan si Ma'am Buendia, gusto na imong mo butang siya og files, no? For example, you're sharing the same subject and Ma'am Buendia has a file in... Asa si Ma'am Buendia? Maka-chat ka, maka-comment ka. Okay ra, ma'am, imo ang itong gamiton as a sample here. Okay, thumbs up. Consent? Okay lang, ma'am? Okay, sige ha. So, if I share this one to Ma'am Buendia, for example, ayan, pwede ko siya gawing editor which she can place files inside the folder or just a viewer. Ano sa diferensya? So sa viewer, makakita, she can only watch all the, no probs. Thank you, Ma'am Vienz. Ma'am Vien. Okay, so if I place her as a viewer, then she can only view what's inside the folder and she could not upload lesson plan or even other resources that you can think of. No? So, for example, gawin ko muna siyang editor. So, hello, ma'am. Sharing with you a folder for our activity. Thanks. Then, so if I send this to her, hopefully she will find an email. Sa email mo to siya mo padulong, informing her that there's a folder which she can upload files here. Okay, pwede mo rin tingnan ang activity. Ayan, so naka-share siya. And of course, the highlight for this afternoon is Google Classroom. So baba na tayo, click natin apps, and you go to Google Classroom. Ito na ang pinaka-highlight, Google Classroom. Now, sa history lang ng Google Classroom, before, you cannot create a classroom in free mode. Google Suite ka sa una. But siguro, daghan na maginangita o Google Classroom, a time came when Google enabled creating a class. So this is again a free account that I have, ayan, no, at gmail.com. Iba kasi yung at Urius ko. So if I click on Urius, for example, by the way, I'm using Firefox and browser, and you can open multiple Google Drives, even Google Classroom. So this is my Google Suite account. Ayan. So on say difference, this is the free account. This is the Suite account. Ayan, Urius. So and difference is, for example, if I go to my algebra class, if you notice here, sa banner, sa kining sa stream area, there's only the title or the description, the section, and then the class code. So here is the class code. If I go to my Google Suite account, there is the description, the section, the class code, but there is a Google Meet link. But again, there are ways to make a Google Meet link appear here. So pwede rin man, like what I did here. Nagbutang ba ko link? Wala. So, gi-free man gihapon ang Google Meet. So you can have, for example, Meet. So you can create, this is for the free, kasi sa Google Suite, you don't need to do this, kasi sa Suite, naana siya daan, ayan, even sa settings, ayan, meron ng Meet. Sa free, if you go sa free, wala, no Meet. Sorry guys, oy Meet. So this is free na account, which you can create a new Meet, for example, get a link to share, then copy that, and then you go back to your free account and then saying, here is our Google Meet for our online meetings, and paste, and then actually pwede mo rin i-click ang add link, and then post. So this is for the free account. Unfortunately, I haven't found a way yet na mugawas ang Gmeet dire lang sa Suite. So ito yung sa Suite. So if you have a DepEd account right now, then it's important for you to explore the DepEd Google Suite account. Okay, so balik tayo sa stream. Again, sa stream, you can announce. Here, nag-announce ako ng website. Nag-announce din ako ng Google Meet. And of course, you can select theme. Ayan, these are predefined themes. In case you don't have an image that you want to upload for the moment, and then you're teaching math, for example, then you have these images. Predefined na siya. May others pa nga, ayan. But if you have an image, of course, you can always click upload. Ano pa bang importante sa stream? Ah, okay. So, in case, let's go back to the very beginning muna. Baka I'm too fast. So, for example, again, we create a class. You click create class. And then, hihingi yan, using classroom at a school, student, if so. Actually, they're really pushing for Google Suite. Suite is free. Just to let you know, Google Suite is free. Of course, pag mag-extend ka o storage files, kasi sa Suite is terabytes, ilan na to ha? Lapas na mo sa 1 terabyte. Pero kasi, ang free dere, ang only cost that you'll have is the domain sa imong website, like urius.edu.ph. So, Urius is paying the domain, urius.edu.ph annually. No, but there are other pricing also for Suite, I guess, no, pa na ako na explore. So you click I've read and understand, click continue. Say for example you're teaching ano ba? Spiral man, so I cannot put algebra, so math for grade 8 section. It depends upon your school if you want to use the current section that they have. Ano ba yung sagusan high? I nakalimot ko na blackout akong mind sa section 8. For example, na lang St. Luke or like that. Then of course, subject gihapon nimo is math for grade 8. And room, kasi nga wala na tayong room physically this time, so we'll be using online. So there, you have it. Already a class. And then it's loading. Oh, ganito kahinay siya karon, ga-loading siya sa akong internet. Ayan. So, congratulations! You now have a new class, Google Class Online, which is has a code. Ayan. And of course, you can always select a theme to change it. So, for example, triangles. Ayan. And of course, classwork, wala pa. So, blank people, wala pa pod. Grades, wala pa pod. It really depends when you're going to give this to your student. Kasi, for the students right now, sa among experience, mas maayong ihatag din mo ning class code kung kompleto na si classworks dire. So, na siya yung mga topics. So, okay. So, for example, tapos ako ang later na lang. So, create topic. For example, lesson 1. It would be good for you to name what lesson 1 is. Kasi kung lesson 1 lang niya, magliro-liro ang bataon sa man nga lesson 1. So, for example, sa may lesson 1 na to. Triangles. Example lang. Lesson 1. So, for example, triangles. Ayan. So, wala pa'y sulod, of course. You can click create. And then, you can click also, ito kasi assignment, quiz assignment, question, are for assessment. Itong material, if you click material, for example, introduction, review na lang kasi grade 8 naman. So, review of triangles, for example. So, this lesson is about reviewing the different types of triangles. Different types of triangles. For example. So, when you make the material, be sure that you're going to click the topic for lesson 1. Yan. Very, very important. And of course, all students. Uy, abdi ka ni Ma'am Rowena. Ano-inol na din siya? Wait sa. Ako sa i-post na ikan, anak ko yung estudyante. Abdi ka ni Ma'am. Uy, kita rin sa code, be. Very good student. Very abdik. Abdi ka ni Ma'am Rowena. Nitanaw sa ako ang class code. See, pakita ninyo ni sa inyong student, yung sulod si student dere, wala pa nahuman ang mga lesson, kapuyan na siya, mag Mobile Legends na din na siya. So, yung anak, mga possible nga mahitabo. Okay, so what else? So, okay, we'll go back to review of triangles para medyo kompletohan po na to si review. Okay. So here, nag-create na kag title, nag-create na kag description for all your students so everyone can see it. In case din mo ganahan mo tanaw si Ma'am Rowena, pwede niyo uncheck. Eh, joke lang. For all students yan. Then triangles, you can now add, pwede ka mag-add kasi ng files if you have files in Google Drive. Okay, so for example, nakay PDF sa imong Google Drive. Ask why na ay uban nga na ay profile sa ila head banner. Asa pa head banner? Sa Google Forms, imong pasabot? Ah, sige, itong tanawin tayo sa ha. Okay, so for example, balik na dali sa itong, muna importante yun si Google Drive. Ayan, no? So that we can create other files here. Pero yung, kasi nag-create naman tag math for grade 8, no? So here in your classroom, naana supposedly si math for grade 8. Ayan, so automatic naghimo na siya og math for grade 8. Ayan. So, naan na siya yung folder. So, for example, gagawa tayo ng, I think, kanang makita dito dapit ng part linin. Sir, pwede ask kayo na ay uban yan. Ay profile sa ila head banner. Kasi dapit kini. Sweet. Tanggalan sila ako si Sweet ha, para dili makuha. Balik ka dali. Save na ba ito? Okay, just to be sure, ask pa sa buti mo, ma'am. Dire? Anyway, kanang makita dito dapit sa part nga lingin sa kilid, sir. Left, right. Kini. Aw. Oh. Sige lang. Ato rin ang tanawin, sir, ma'am, later, pag moment. Oo. Balikan na ito na. Please call my attention later. Kaya mo intriga ako anong may profile dere. So, balik sa ta. Sana yun. So, for example, na kay types of triangles. Example lang, mag-search ka. And then, just to be sure, it's a PDF file. So, magda-download tayo ng some PDF types of triangles. What I'm going to show you is if meron kang file sa imong Google Classroom. So, for example, ito yung na-download siya. So, na-download na si types of triangles. And then, muna yung nakanindot ni Google Drive. Because if this is your Google Drive, and this is your Windows Explorer, for example, kini, unfortunately, I'm not sure sa cellphone ha, pero this one's easier. Yes, ma'am. Yan na lang tad-tad, ma'am, para mabalikan na to. You can easily drag the file to your Google Drive. Ayan. So, money na kanindot sa Google Drive. Ayan. So, in case na kay file na si mong Google Drive, if you go back here, sa imong classroom, and oops, sorry. I'm going to edit again the material. Pwede ta mag-add o file from Google Drive. My Drive. At tumutong gibutang ni Matt. So sa kadaghanan na akong classes dire, nasa na yan Matt for grade 8. Dire ba ito ng gibutang? Ayan. So na si types of triangles. Pwede ni mo ipakita sa isa ka student or tanan. So you have this one. And then pwede din, for example, link, just in case. I'm fond of using math is fun. So, tanaw na ito ko na by triangles. Yan. So, grabe ko ka-avid fan ni math is fun. So, I love the way they present mathematics in their, the funny way they present mathematics here in their website. So the link is here. Imula siyang control C or right click, copy. You go back to your classroom, add the link, paste. And then there you have another link for the lesson review of triangles. Ano pa ba? In case you want to have your own flavor of the triangles, so create ka. You can either you have your own Google Docs, which is a substitute for Google Microsoft Word, Microsoft Excel, PowerPoint, drawing forms. So if you want to create a slide, pwede rin click na slide. This will activate the slide. Tapos gawa ka ng presentation. So this is like your own flavor. Meaning ikaw. Not from other sources. So types of triangles. So for example, like that. Oh. Uy, naghang na po. Ayan. So types of triangles by Sir Orly, Orlando. So for example, now this one, supposedly kini imong gihimo nga slide should also be available in here, your classroom file. So ayan, andyan din si types of triangles. Stick lang.
Okay, kasi. Ang gamit ko.
Okay, so ito yung new normal. My daughter is knocking at the door, asking for the cell phone. Sabi ko, gamit sa anak ko. So welcome to our work at home. Asan ako? So we created a Google Slide, which is inside Google Classroom. Ayan. Supposedly, dapat ito, i-save natin. So once we save it, ayan. So meron kang file from your folder, a link, and then kini your old flavor. Then napaka-i-add kasi, pero again ha, caution lang po kasi not all students have access sa videos. So for example, hilig ka mag-YouTube. So sa YouTube, although we like it in video mode, not all students can always access a, so for example, types of triangles. So ayan, dami. So a very, very important phrase in learning is you don't need to always reinvent the wheel. So ang dami nang ginawa dyan on triangles and issues, for example, you can, I hope na this is public man ng YouTube, so you can always like use one. And if you have time,
Grammarly does more than catch errors.
Okay, sorry, the advertisement. Okay, so and if you want to interact with the author, probably you can dig in further. No? Kaya tingnan natin kung may share link. Ayan, meron siyang share link. So copy. Then you can go back here. Same Google Classroom, and also you can add a link or even YouTube. Ito link na ngayon kanina eh. Actually, YouTube, you'll be going to a window for the YouTube. Pwede rin yung URL. Supposedly, ayan. Then you add. There you have it. So you have a file from your computer that you've downloaded. You have a link from the website. And then here is your flavor, meaning ikaw yung naghimuani, and then, of course, you have a video, and then you're done. That's lesson one in the materials. Now, of course, I think, it's important that you give a, ang tawag natin nun, diagnostic test before they take this this lesson and all the learnings that you would have here, because it's important for you to know kung sa level of learning sa estudyante. Now, you can click on quiz assignment. And for example, this is, we can formally call this as diagnostic test. Diagnostic test. Tama ba ko, ma'am? Email address. Teka lang. Tara, ma'am. Email. Oh, ito ang email ko ina. Email address na ako daw. Ayan. So here's my email, ma'am, for Ma'am Imelda. Friends na tayo sa pag-email. Thanks lang sa kilid. Ayan. Okay, so diagnostic test, review ta, ano ba to? Magnanang instruction. And then, click on the blank quiz form. Ayan. So, nandito tayo sa Google form na naman. And, we can name this as diagnostic test to determine the current knowledge of the student. Okay. Supposedly, ito yung automatic pangalan dyan. And pag gusto ni mo na siya ay customized theme sa header, of course, you can choose gusto niyo upload whatever photos you'd like. Ano ba to? Travel. Hindi man travel. Work in school man siya. It's something about almost close to mathematics, science, reading, coffee. Ayan, kasi sasakit ulo mo sa coffee. So, coffee and math. Hanay paper clips. So, diagnostic test. And, okay. This is the part where I love math is fun. For those who are teaching mathematics. Take note that I hated mathematics when I was young. Siguro bunga rin sa terror na teacher na ako, so wag ko ganahan. So anyway, going back to math is fun, triangle. If I scroll down, there are sample questions here that I can utilize. Okay. Oh my God, how I'm going to draw a shape. This shape is. Okay, so what I do, kung Windows, kung nakay Windows di ha, you can use, ano ba yung sa Windows ginagamit? Paint. No, paint just to cut and paste here. Now, for those who are using Mac, naka-Mac, mag-Command-Shift lang kasi ako, I can just highlight a part here. Ayan. Part here for the image. So, for example, triangle 1. So, of course, I need to put that image here also sa akong Google Drive. So, that's why very, very important gid talaga ang Google Drive. So, I'm going to put triangle 1 here. Sample lang to. If possible, siguro we could have another session na makatutok gid siya. I only have, I think, 15 minutes before 4, sir, no? So I'll just finish this one quiz and we can go back to my final presentation. Sana ba yun? Ayan. So, kasi sa titled question, ang sabi niya, this shape is, at the same time, you can actually add a photo here. So from your Google Drive. Supposedly na recent, but as a classroom, asa nakalocate yung map, and then triangles here, how it's loading, this shape is, of course, naka option 1, right and angled, pwede mo rin, lagay lang ganyan, and copy paste. And then of course this is a quiz, so kailangan gawin natin make this a quiz. Okay na siya, collect email. Limit to one response. You can shuffle the questions. You can also show progress bar. And the answer is a regular equilateral triangle. So, of course, don't forget the points here. Sabi natin 5 points yan. And you're done. Okay, ito lang muna for now. Just one diagnostic test na hopefully nandito na sa classwork again. Due date. Ito yung time. Pwede ka kasi mag-set ng date. So for example, it's due now at 5 p.m. Tama ba? Ayan, 5 p.m. And the topic is lesson 1. No need for rubric. Hopefully na siya. Na-change kasi nag- save man siya dito gayina. Okay, so be. Ayan, andun na si diagnostic. Pwede na mo mag-take of diagnostic test, ma'am. Okay, so tanggalin muna natin 'to at maka-focus ta sa samples lang. Sa people again, nanay nag-enroll. Grades for the moment, ang diagnostic test ang nakabutang kay. Ito mo siyang ibutang sa classroom. Okay, so ano pa ba? Let's go back to my presentation. Ayan. So we created already an email. Meron, makalocate tayo ng Google Drive. Google Classroom, meron tayong sample class with a sample of the diagnostic test. Ito naman sa website, before kumuend sa akong talk, I think I only have 5 minutes. So now we have a lesson, itong lesson one triangles. At the side of this, there is copy link. You know, copy link. Ayan. If I go to my Google Drive and I'm going to create, right click, new folder, Google site. For example, sabihin ko na lang, Math 8 Look. Himo kong folder nga Math 8 Look so that I could right click again. Right click kasi ganong himoon so that I could easily navigate, no? Then I click Google Site, create and share. Now, you can work Google Site and Google Classroom hand in hand. So, paano? Ito yung bonus ko for 5 minutes. Madalian. So, for example lang, this is Math 8. Oops. Sorry. Math 8. Yan. And Math 8. And then insert welcome to grade 8 math. Yan, gawin natin fun. Diba, you remember dito, the lesson 1, I click on copy link. So sa website here, click mo lang insert button. And sabihin natin, lesson 1, triangles. You're going to paste there the link sa imong Google Classroom. And now you have now a website, publish Math 8 gawin natin. May lagwa pa nakakwag Math 8. Taken, sorry. Oh, Math 8 Look. Ah, wala, Math 8 Look. So click mo publish. And ladies and gentlemen, if you go to a website, oh, ito, sites.google.com/view/Math 8 Look. What they can see is a website. And if naka-sign in sila sa Google, if they click that, automatically they go to your lesson 1. Charan! So anyway, more on that soon. Kung gusto nyo pa. So yun yung bonus. And I think I'm almost done. Baka 10 minutes questions. So, let's check ourselves. I hope katong nag-email sa kuha na create na mo email folder for your sample class. Na create ka o Google Drive folder and also you located where Google Classroom is found in your Google Drive. And the third one is you have developed a Google Classroom. Sample lang muna. Anyway, you can contact me or contact the officers kung sa manggani kung na may questions. And bonus, katong dinalian is working with Google website and the Google Classroom. So these are the references. I'm going to share naman this slide so that you can click. Kasi yung emoji, nakalimutan ko. Ito yung emoji na ay na emoji sa gilid like this one. No? Yan. Like this na world na emoji sa gilid sa imuhang. Ayan. Exploring the world of unknowns. So na ako emoji ng world. So that's it for this afternoon. Daghang salamat. And kung may questions, sa comments lang. And thank you for bearing with me despite the weather. Stop screen share na, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir. Our engineer, Orlando, for that very, nalisa ka sa mga feathers.
Grabe,
for that very... informative talk. Salamat kayo, Sir Richie. We're looking forward.
Many more hi.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much for the information ngayon mong gihatag sa amo. So at this point, mga kaguro, please type your questions in the comment sections. Or in the comment section so that Sir Orlando Natuntun can answer your queries and then para matubag ko kung sa inyong mga dughan. Okay, so shout out sa tanan. Sample, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Napa daw ni Sunod na event. So, hoping na pa'y next nga event
sana,
na
sana.
Mahatag sa ato. Natin, part 2, I mean, looking forward for the part 2. Wala ba tayong evaluation, sir? Output only. We have our evaluation, so we will give the link right after mahuman ang question and answer portion with Sir Orly. Okay, so please, wala pa ko nakita ang mga questions. Questions in the comment section. Question from Losmindo Penos.
Hi, sir.
Kaya ba sa Google Classroom ang baratuhon nga cellphone sa bukid o niya hinay ang signal?
Not sure about that. Pero sa cellphone, unsa nga baratuhon? Basig na 3,000. Namay mga cellphone ako nabantayan karon nga less than 5,000, I guess, nga maka-Mobile Legends. So, i-testing lang, kasi ganun ka na maka-Mobile Legends, manggod, na asley faster nga processor, just in case, i-download sa Google Apps, Google Play DI, ang Google Classroom. Try lang, sir. Nanamog yung mga barato mga cellphone karon nga for the sake of playing Mobile Legends, and dili ban basta-basta ang Mobile Legends nga process nga needed processor speed diha. I-try lang sir niya Google Play.
Okay, so just keep on trying.
Yun lang,
next
trial
question. Correct. From Ben Bendia, pwede ra ba ma-adjust tong time sir sa diagnostic na imong gi-post?
Yeah. Yes, pwede siya.
Pwede ra daw.
Pwede gawing, for example, this happened to me sa midterm exam. And I have a deadline. Kaya lang, ang student has brand out. Internet connection problems. Now, what I learned sa LaSalle ODL is, these are all first times sa ato tanan, so we have to be very forgiving. We can adjust. So, don't worry, ma-adjust siya ang date and even ang time. So for example, sir, pwede ma-adjust sa 5 days? So pwede siya sa Google Classroom.
Okay, so sana lahat ma-adjust, sir, no? Sir, can we still watch this video in YouTube after this webinar? Hahabol lang po kaming medyo may problema sa signal. I think this is recorded.
Recorded, Manina. So recorded, maybe they can replay the part that I made some actual demo, siguro pwede nila balikan to.
Sige, so more questions?
Nadagan ng email sa
sir, pwede ba siya nga direct sila magutana sa imo through email or through Facebook? Kung na sila mga problema,
email. I would prefer email kay mas ang Facebook naglunop na daghan kaayo nya basi di na ko ma-entertain ng uban, so email lang po, email sa akong icon.
Yes, so pwede na sa through email.
Pwede mo sir na ko i-post sa comment de comments ay private chat. Here's my email tapos yung slide. Sige lang, ako li post ang link sa website so that you can download the slide nga akong gi-present kanina.
Yes. Thank you so much. So I think wala na lang mga pangutana. If you have still questions, then this is the time for you to ask. Okay, para ma-address na to kang Sir Richie. Kung kasagaran mag-una address sa comment, isa pasalamat. So they're looking forward for the part 2.
Part
webinar.
Two.
So, part 2. So, mag-expect na kada answer Richie nga nagi part 2.
Excited.
From Unil Senses, possibly ba sir nga ang timed exam automatic checking like sa Edmodo?
Ah, okay. Checking. Kasi yung sa Google Form, form ato yung sagutan. Sa Google Form, di ba nagbutang mong kuugad tong answer key. So the minute mag-click siya submit, that's the only time nga mo answer siya tanan. There was an experience sa akong student nga wa niya na-click ang submit man siguro and then na-abta na siya time ni kalit og submit. So I'll try to look into that. Pero at Edmodo, that was only a long time ago nga akong check ang Edmodo eh. Sa Google Forms, what I know is you have to click submit para ma-send yun. Now, in case mo lapas siya, I need to review on that kung automatic ba or mabagsak naman sa mga estudyante once mo lapas siya. So you can send me an email po, sir, sa kana nga query para matanawa na ako siya og ma-check, ma-trial and error.
Thank you, sir. From Lerma Sarse, sir, murag laptop man, murag nasa ituan. Murag laptop man ang dapat gamiton kay naay line contents nga dili ma-view pag cellphone ang gamiton. So
yes,
siguro laptop tanan.
If you will create a class, advisable gid ang laptop or desktop if you will create a class. But if you will launch the classroom already and already conduct a class, pwede ra man siya cellphone or tab. Pero yung creation talaga ng classroom, mas advisable ang laptop or desktop, ma'am.
Okay, so is there an e-certificate for this webinar? Yes, we will be giving e-certificate after sa kadtong evaluation form. So if maka-fill up mo evaluation form, then we will send you the e-certificate. Sir Geron, back to you.
Sir, naawang tanya din, sir, nag-text sa ako. Kung ano, sir, kanang naba daw limit ang Google Classroom?
Isa ha? Ah, okay lang. I'm sending a... Pakicheck sa akong gisend nga link, sirs, kung ma-access na ninyo ang PDF nga akong gisend, akong gishare. Okay, okay, limit. Ha? Alam ko kasi, ano eh, 1,000 man siguro to. I forgot to include that.
Pero kanang preferred number of students sir sa Google Classroom?
Okay, ako I had 178 na I can show you siguro. Basta I had one time. Ito, class member teachers personal account 250. Can you please pwede share sa akong screen na ako kadali?
Ah sige sir.
Yes sir.
Okay na. Screen one yung siguro ito. Ayan. Na-share na ako, sir. Pakikuan na lang, sir. Kuan siya. For personal account, ayan, no? For personal account, ito yung 15 gigabyte. Teachers per class, maximum of 20. Ang class members, teachers, and students, 250. Ang 1,000 di ay, moms and sir, is for Google Suite. That's, for example, naakay at DepEd at edu.ph. But then again, please be careful, kay kung naakay at DepEd at edu.ph, ang makasulod rapod sa imong Google Classroom are emails nga naay at DepEd@edu.ph. Dili makasulod si free. Pero kung free account, which is ito, you have 20 teachers max, then 250 ang iyahang students. So, pwede siguro tanawin niyo.
For example, sir, ang mga public school teacher, so naamang git sila yung mga DepEd account, so dapat ang ilang gamiton is Gmail, personal
yeah, okay.
account.
Sir Geron, I was thinking of this actually before pata sa seminar sa orientation karon is kasi namoy DepEd account, I know the DepEd teachers have a at DepEd.edu.ph, so that's good, namoy Google Suite. Unfortunately, pag imo i-launch ni sa mga estudyante nimo, dili na sila kasulod sa imong classroom kay at DepEd.edu.ph at unless kada isa sa estudyante hatagan nimo at DepEd.edu.ph. So yun yung iniisip ko, yun yung mahirap. So, unfortunately, siguro sa next session na ako ipakita itong crucial nga Google Suite nga technique sa Google Form. Okay, for example, I have 1,000 students taking the quiz or exam. Unsaon nimo pag isa-isa sa ilang mga scores ibutang sa imong class record. Ang Google Suite has a import button. Automatic ma-import nimo tanan scores sa imong Google Classroom. Ang free wala. So unfortunately, yun yung sa free account. So best advice, since you will have students that doesn't have DepEd.edu.ph, please explore more ang free account na to.
Yes, sir. So dapat kida sir, parehas mo domain.
Yes po.
Para makasulod yun sila.
Sir, na daw nag-send sa imong email sa
yes,
orlando.gmail.com. Basi question, murag na yung mga missing link sa iya, and then ikaw rin makatubag na sa mga pangutana.
Oh,
from Ira.
Kisa?
Ira.
Ayan. May si Ma'am Bragan, Ma'am Ruena?
Si Magala. Si Magala.
Magala. M-A-G-A-L, yung apelido? Unsa yung gigamit niya sa email, sir?
Katong orlandonatonton@gmail.com.
Okay. Kinsipangan sa teacher, sir, nga nangunguta na ron.
Magala? Era. Era. Oh, si Magala. Si Magala.
Ah, si Mag... S-I. Si Ma...
C-I Magala.
Ay, ito, okay.
Magala.
Kuya, gini si Gmail. So, na siya gi-email. Di na ako makita yung photo. That's why I was asking. Oo. Ako lang siyang, nag-reply na ko sa iya ha, kung sa itong picture.
Okay, sir. Okay, so please give us an ample time for the evaluation considering the speed of our internet connection. Salamat po. Okay, so the officers will post now the evaluation at the comment. I think Nana posted na ang evaluation, ang link sa evaluation. So you can now open the link para makakuan mo sa evaluation. So shout out to all the participants of this webinar. Thank you so much. From the teachers from Dinagat, from Surigao, Agusan del Sur, Agusan del Norte, Butuan City,
soon.
Daghan kayong salamat. And
thank
yes,
you
see you soon. And special
welcome,
thanks
sir.
To the people behind. Salamat kay Ma'am Hazel, Ma'am Jet, Sir Edmond, Sir Geron, Sir Princeton, Ma'am Marie Chris, Sir Jay, Sir Azahel, and the rest of the officers. And of course, batch 1999, ang bagtik ng batch.
Thank you.
And of course, to our dynamic dean. Daghang salamat, Ma'am Arlene Floreta, for
yes,
the support
Arlene,
sa alumni association.
Sir Edmond, thank you.
Back to you, Sir Duran.
Yes, so daghang gang salamat, Sir Alan, Sir Natuntun. So we are looking forward for the next webinar of the Hugpong Alumni. So to our participants all over Caraga region, daghang kayong salamat. And please wait 1 week. We will be distributing your e-certificates. Sir Alan, napaka-dugang, sir.
Thank you.